Hello, my mathematicians. Today we are going to be looking at lesson 6.3, which is about estimating the sums and differences of fractions. And you can find this on page 363 and 364 in your book to follow along and fill in your notes. So, the first problem we have is 1/6 and 3/8. So the first thing we're going to do in order to estimate this answer, because we're not actually going to solve it today, but the first thing we're going to do to actually estimate is to round to the nearest benchmark. Our benchmarks when working with fractions tend to be 0, 1/2, and 1. So those are the benchmarks that we're going to look at, okay? So we're going to start with 1/6. So I already have a number line made out here, and you have a number line in your book. And I'm going to mark where 1/6 is on that number line. So it is right there. You can see it, I'll circle it here so they make sure you can see it on the screen. So which benchmarks is that 1/6 between? Look at our benchmarks, they're 0, 1/2, and 1. And the 1/6 falls between the 0 and the 1/2. So we're going to go 0, 1/2. Now, which is it closest to? Well, here's the 1/2. It has to go 1, 2 jumps to get to the 1/2. It only has a good 1 jump to get to the 0, so it's closest to the 0. So we're going to round to 0. Now, if we have 3/8, I again have the number line made up, we have our benchmarks of 0, 1/2, and 1. So we're going to find 3/8 on the number line, which is right here. And again, I'll circle it to make it a little bit more obvious. And we want to look, which two benchmarks is it between? Well, it's between 0, and it's between 1/2 again. Which benchmark, then, is it closest to? Well, we have 1 jump to the 1/2, and 1, 2, 3 jumps to 0, so it's going to be closest to 1/2. So we're going to round to 1/2. So now we're going to take this. We have 1/6 plus 3/8. The 1/6 is going to become 0, and the 3/8 is going to become 1/2. So what is 0 plus 1/2? That equals 1/2. So our estimation to this problem is 1/2. Now, the same process works when we are working with subtraction, but we don't always have a number line with us to figure out what benchmark we're closest to. So we can kind of look at our numbers and we can just kind of round. I'm going to use some references. So this is 1 and this is 1/2. So we have 9/10 minus 5/8. So 9/10, you may be able to look at it and know which one it's closest to, but you may have to look that these are each 1/10. So there's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So which one is that line closest to? Is it closest to the 1, or is it closest to the 1/2? Well, it's obviously closest to the 1, because it's almost 1. So 9/10 rounds to 1. We're going to do the same thing with the 5/8. Again, you may be able to look at it and know which one it's closest to, but you might not. So we're going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Which one is it closest to? Well, It's a little bit bigger than the 1/2, but it's a lot closer to the 1/2 than it is to the whole. If you move this down and look at it. So it's going to round to 1/2. Okay. So now we subtract. The 9/10 again is becoming 1. The 5/8 is becoming 1/2. And if you have one whole, you take away half, it's going to leave you with a half. So 1/2 is your answer to this problem. Now, I want to make sure that you are not only watching this, but that you are listening. So I want you, on top of this lesson page, I want you to draw a smiley face if you're watching this. And then I'm going to give you a couple problems to solve and want you to rate your level of understanding using this to 5. And again, when you're solving, you're just estimating. So you're going to find the benchmark that's closest to, and then you're going to add or subtract those benchmarks, not the actual problem. Okay?